of India and Zambia, Mr. Mukulu Makasa, Acting Director General, Zambia Development Agency, Mr. Shailendra Bansal, my colleague at ESC and member ESC Africa Committee, Mr. Gurmeet Singh, ED ESC. Excellency, at the outset, I would like to thank you for supporting us and making this event happen today. I am sure that this initiative will go a long way in cementing the ties between the two countries and IT companies especially. Taking quick snapshot on Electronic Software and Export Promotion Council, we call it ESC. ESC collectively represent about 2,500 companies from both segments, software and electronic hardware. In the last year, we clocked export turnover of about $155 billion from India, which is really a fantastic figure in terms of the export from single group from India. Intend to keep growing at a reasonable rate. Having said so, I realize that there is a pressure on us because of this pandemic. India and Zambia, our relationship is quite old. We are in existence and having cultural relationship between the two countries for thousands of years. But recently, we have acknowledged, we have seen that the relationship is getting developed and growing, maturing. With the recent visit of President of Zambia, His Excellency Mr. Edgar Lungu, we have seen that the bilateral trade and the initiatives for working together has enhanced. We have signed six bilateral agreements recently. India has also taken the initiative for line of credit. Excellency would probably bring in more light. What I understand is that the line of credit is also focused on the IT sector, especially where we see a lot of opportunities. And this B2B event of today will also take us long way in that direction. If I talk of the IT, I think I'll just simply say that India is a power center in IT and ITS. The Indian companies possess a great skill set, which together with the resources that Zambia has and the market that Zambia has access to, can actually bring in a lot of mutual business growth for both the countries and the companies from both the sides. I hope that today's event will further be in the direction to have the growth path, and I will not take much of the time. I would let other speakers speak, and then B2B meeting where the members from the both industry side can collaborate and talk. With these words, I would conclude my opening remarks, and I thank you all for being here, and I hope all I wish for success. Thank you.
Thank you, Sandeep ji. Mr. Sandeep Rula, the Chairman of the Electronics and Computer Software Export Promotion Council, for his introductory remarks and a quick and very crisp introduction about the ESE, our trade, and common ICT scenario within the country. Thank you so much once again, Sandeep ji. With this, may I request Mr. Shailendra Bansal, Member ESE Africa Committee and Managing Director, Embark Information Technology Private Limited, to please share his welcome address.
Thank you, Gobi ji. Good morning to my friends from Zambia and good afternoon, friends from India. His Excellency Mr. N. J. Gangpe, High Commissioner of India to Zambia, Mr. Sandeep Narula, Chairman ESC, Mr. Mukula Makase, Acting Director General, Zambia Development Agency, Mr. Gurmeet Singh, Executive Director ESC, our industry friends from both India and Zambia, ladies and gentlemen. I feel privileged to address this August gathering, and on behalf of Electronics and Computer Software Export Promotion Council, it gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all. I extend a very special welcome to Mr. N.J. Gangpe, High Commissioner of India to Zambia. I also take this opportunity to welcome Mr. Mukula Makase, Acting Director General, Zambia Development Agency, and senior executives of leading Zambian and Indian companies. India and Zambia share a long history of culture and economic cooperation. Many Indians, particularly from Gujarat, have settled in Zambia and have contributed greatly to the economy as traders, manufacturers, producers, and professionals. God has blessed Zambia with abundant natural resources. Zambia has a lot to offer to tourists as well, whether it is the Lungwa National Park in the north or the breathtaking Victoria Falls in the south. Currently, the trade between India and Zambia is mostly dominated by exports from Zambia. There's a lot of scope for ICT-related activities in Zambia. Zambia is one of the several countries in the Southern African region that has sought to include ICTs in their national development plans. Bharti Airtel started their operations in Zambia in 2010 and are now one of the biggest mobile operators there. One big advantage in working with Zambia is that the main language is English. Friends, India is the world's largest sourcing destination for IT. The industry contributes significantly to the social and economic transformation of the country. It is important to highlight that India's IT exports worth $145 billion and electronics hardware exports worth $11 billion in 2019-20 speaks volumes of success. I myself have visited Zambia and found Zambians to be very friendly and receptive to Indians. I would encourage Indian ICT companies to engage with friendly Zambian companies and work for mutual benefits. I will not take much of the time, as our industry friends on both sides will be eager to exchange their offerings. Before I conclude, let me highlight that the Council will be organizing the next edition of its flagship event, IndiaSoft 2021, on 24th-25th March 2021. I invite all our Zambian friends to visit the event to witness a world of IT innovations. We had a large delegation from Zambia at the last edition of IndiaSoft 2020 held in March this year. Thank you very much, both sides, and wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Shailendra Bansalji. I think that was quite quick and quite informative. And thank you so much again for extending a very warm invite to our Zambian companies to join us for next edition of IndiaSoft, which is going to take place sometime in March. Not sure, most likely we will be doing a virtual event this time because of the current scenario. And we would like to have a larger participation, and we seek the similar kind of a cooperation from our embassy, our High Commission, to invite more and more Zambian companies to interact with Indian companies at this virtual platform. With this, sir, it's a pleasure to hand over the dais to you, and we look forward to hearing from you, your insight, and the market opportunities in Zambia. And again, thank you so much for organizing today's interaction between the ICT industries from both the sides. Thank you so much, Excellency Mr. Nangte. Over to you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Gumbit. Mr. Sandeep Narula, Chairman, Electronics and Computer Software Export Promotional Council of India. Mr. Gurmeet Singh, Executive Director, ESC. Mr. Shailendra Bansal, Member, ESC Africa Committee. Mr. Mukula Makasa, Acting Director General, Zambia Development Agency. Representatives of Smart Zambia and business community in Zambia. Representatives of Indian IT industry. Friends, good morning and good afternoon. A hearty welcome to each one of you. I mean, for those of you who are from joining us from India, from Zambia. It's a delight for me to address the first virtual business meet between Indian IT industry and the business community in Zambia. I'd like to thank the Electronics and Computer Software Export Promotion Council of India and its Executive Director, Mr. Gurmeet Singh, for hosting the first business meet. My thanks is also due to all the representatives of the government of Zambia, Zambian industry, and Indian IT companies who have participated in this. Information and communications technology has become one of the most crucial ingredients influencing economic and societal productivity. In the times of pandemic, the role of ICT has been exceptional. One cannot imagine of business in the absence of technologies which we now take for granted. This virtual B2B itself is made possible because of the advances made in the ICT world. For the benefit of our friends from India who may not be familiar with Zambia, Zambia is a population of approximately 17 to 18 million. The country is geographically, strategically located in the heart of Southern Africa, sharing borders with 8 countries. It is a landlocked but landlink country. As a member of both SADC and COMESA trade groupings, it presents market of $360 million. Zambia is the second largest copper in Africa, with the copper mining sector contributing about 20% of GDP and 70% of its earnings. Mining, agriculture, and tourism are the largest sectors of the economy. The political stability and steady economic performance of Zambia has made it a lucrative destination for trade and investment. Friendly ties between India and Zambia are long-standing, multidimensional, and on a firm footing of mutual trust and fraternity solidarity. The economic and development cooperation partnership is pivotal in this relationship. Indo-Zambia trade in the calendar year 2019 was over $1 billion, with the balance of trade in favor of Zambia. India's imports from Zambia stood at $760 million, primarily comprised of copper, manganese, lead, semi-precious stones, and butter. India's export is a diversified basket comprising of pharmaceuticals, healthcare equipment, vehicles and spare parts, electrical equipment and machinery, plastic products, food items. This B2B with the Indian IT is timely, in fact, overdue. Way back, the government of Zambia had identified the rollout of information technology as a catalyst to spur Zambia's economic development into a middle-income country by 2030. Towards this end, Zambia has embraced the fourth industrial revolution with the launch of the Smart Zambia project in 2015. The project is envisaged to integrate and ensure interoperability of the computing systems of the different ministries, departments, and agencies of the government, with a view to provide efficient public services delivery to citizens and business entities. The first phase of the project was accomplished in 2017 with the establishment of the Zambia National Data Center and includes the development of Zambia's broadband system. India's Tata Consultancy Services played a key role in the development of Zambia's online tax system, integrating and providing a platform for direct and indirect tax. ICT encompasses all sectors of economic activity from health, hospitality, and farm to finance. Latest technologies such as data analytics and big data, Internet of Things, cloud computing, blockchain, artificial intelligence, robotics, quantum computing, etc., has the potential to transform the pivotal sectors of the Zambian economy, including agriculture and finance. The $200 billion Indian IT industry, which Mr. Sandeep Arora had just mentioned, stood at the exports has the resources, expertise, and capacities to support Zambia in this endeavor. I'm confident and optimistic that the Indian IT companies will be able to find enough opportunities for Zambian manufacturers and businesses in their quest for achieving higher scales of innovation, industrialization, and digitization at affordable cost. I'm hopeful that this virtual B2B meeting will be the first of a series of such meetings, which provide the platform for regular interaction between the Indian and Zambian business communities and forge mutually beneficial partnerships. I would again like to thank the Electronics and Computer Software Export Promotion Council for this opportunity and wish the meeting success. Thank you and have a very good day.
Thank you so much, Excellency. As you rightly observed, technology is the main driving force in the major economies globally. And we are happy that even within during the current crisis time, during the COVID time, the Indian IT industry has really excelled. And after Y2K solutions, industry has developed and delivered quite innovative solutions during the COVID period, and presented an example to the global companies by working from home and even remain operational during these difficult times. So thank you so much for your kind words and the vision and the support for today's virtual meet. And we look forward, I am sure, under your leadership, there are exports or our trade between the two countries are bound to grow. With these words, thank you so much again. With these words, can I request our next esteemed panelist, Mr. Mukula Makasa, Acting Director General, Zambia Development Agency, to kindly share his vision and opportunities for cooperation between the two countries in the ICT sector. Over to you, Mr. Mukula Makasa.
Thank you very much, Director of Ceremonies. Your Excellency, Dante, High Commissioner of India to Zambia, Ms. Gurmeet Singh, Executive Director, Electronics and Computer Software Export Promotion Council, Mr. Shailendra Bansal, Member of ESC Committee and Managing Director, Back Information Technology Limited, government officials present, stakeholders, all companies present at this meeting from both India and Zambia, management and staff from the Zambia Development Agency, members of the press corps, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Once more, I'd like to say good morning. I'd like to take this opportunity first and foremost to welcome you to the India-Zambia virtual B2B meeting on trade opportunities between our two countries. The virtual B2B meeting is aimed at creating and facilitating market linkages and business opportunities between our two countries, the business enterprises in our two countries. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, the Zambia Development Agency coordinated private sector participation at the 20th India Soft Exposition 2020 in Hyderabad from the 3rd to 4th March 2020, at which 5 Zambian companies from the IT sector participated. The 20th India Soft Exposition was funded by the Indian government through and Computer Promotion Council. The 20th edition, India Soft Exposition 2020, was a business networking event which facilitated joint ventures, strategic alliances, and collaboration overseas and Indian companies for enhancing IT business partnerships, which comprised international exhibition and business-to-business networking meetings. The objectives and outcomes of the 20th India Soft Exposition 2020 were in line with the Zambia Development Agency's mandate of fostering economic growth and diversification, facilitating local and international market linkages, as well as trade and investment opportunities for the private sector. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I'm glad to note that our relationship and networking arising from the India Soft Exposition has brought us together again today. You will agree with me that COVID impacted the world, the whole world, and has ultimately changed the way we conduct business throughout the entire globe. Both the public and private sector alike have had to resort to alternative ways of doing business, including working from home and conducting meetings virtually. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, the effectiveness of such strategies requires the right ICT software and hardware in place. Therefore, the B2B meeting we are convening today is providing the right platform for Zambian companies to outsource from India, the appropriate technology and tools for use now in the new normal and future. You will definitely agree with me that the COVID-19 pandemic has taught us and hence invest in appropriate ICT software and equipment. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, India has demonstrated its ability to develop new technology and adapt to the challenges of our time by providing cutting-edge ITC services, emerging as a champion even in this crisis. India IT services, which is part of the ICT sector, a top Indian export and the largest private sector employer in the country. The sector depends on high-quality infrastructure, which the Indian government has been helping to build. Hence, I urge all the Zambian business enterprises present to make use of this platform to create trade linkages. Ladies and gentlemen, to this effect, the agency as the driver of the economic development agenda in Zambia is excited to partner with the ESC, and it is our sincere hope that this meeting will be a win-win for the two countries and participating business enterprises. Guests, ladies and gentlemen, I wish you all the best as you fully take advantage of this meeting that will yield tangible business deals and exchange of information for the benefit of our two friendly countries. I wish you fruitful discussions. Thank you. Dania Ba.
Thank you very much, Mr. Makasa, for your encouraging words. And we certainly value our strong relationship and your always available support to ESE and its initiative in connecting the industry from both the sides in the ICT sector. And we look forward to your active participation under your leadership and in association with our High Commission there in the next virtual meet. I am sure today's meeting will further the way for both the industries to discuss, network, and cooperate with each other for a win-win situation. There's no doubt about it. And thank you so much for joining us today and supporting the events today. With these words, our intro session is over. And I request my colleague Vikrant to please invite company one by one from the Indian side, followed by the Zambian side, so that they can briefly introduce themselves to each other. And then we have already shared the database for these companies, our Indian companies, with the Zambian side, so that once you are identify the company that you want to work with, you can continue networking with those companies and working with those companies over email, WhatsApp groups, and whatever that. And in any case, wherever you feel our intervention or our intervention is required, we are always there to welcome and we look forward to hear from you for any business opportunities that's looking from India to work with Indian companies. With these words, Vikrant, hand over to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Gurmeet. Am I audible?
Yes, okay. You're audible.
Yeah, thanks a lot. So let me start by inviting Ms. Yasha from AM WebTech. Yasha, please.
Hello, everyone. This is Sonam. And though Yasha is here, I take the opportunity to speak on behalf of AM WebTech Private Limited. Good morning to Zambia. Good afternoon to India. AM WebTech Private Limited help businesses to utilize digital platforms to open new doors of business opportunities. These digital systems are predictable, controllable, easy to adopt, and provide consistent business growth. We have 50 plus pro experts that serve to convert an idea into a success. We are based in Indore, India, and it isn't a limit for us, as we are proud of serving more than 500 clients across the globe and adding it continuously. The key activities we are involved in are web design and development, QA services, GIS application development, SaaS application development, digital marketing, Google Cloud Server, Google Map API. And I must say that we are not bounded with the technology stake. In fact, we always focus to give a digital platform that provides you consistent business growth. Thank you.
Thank you, Sonam. May I now invite Mr. Sudhir Gandotra? Mr. Sudhir Gandotra.
Yes, please. Good day to everybody. I'll go through a very brief introduction of ours, which I have put in the chat box also. We are a technology company and we focus on books domain. Today, we have provided over the last 4 years, very affordable library automation to educational institutions, which has resulted in these institutions getting world's best services and saving overall a little more than $5 million. We have brought down the rates to very, very affordable for any institution. Today, we manage and support libraries across 30 countries, including many in Africa, like Botswana, Congo, Ghana, Kenya, Malawi, Mozambique, Namibia, Nigeria, Uganda, and Zimbabwe. And we look forward to adding more countries, more partners. We publish new authors, charging them only $35 per book. We help publishers sell their books at economical rates, but still with better ROI to libraries. We help transform students to become authors, thus improving their reading abilities, which has direct effect on their scores, their employability, and it enhances their intellectual abilities. We have the ability of not only automating all the libraries of Zambia at a very affordable rates, but we can also connect all of them together for book discovery and book sharing across the country, across the libraries. We offer the best and yet the most affordable video conference solution, which is our second product, which is available at www.thesuji.com. And in the chat, we have given a link of our website where all these details are mentioned. And we invite the ICT companies of Zambia to come forward and discuss business, to be business partners for mutually business beneficial results immediately. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Sudhir. May I now request Mr. Amit Vachar from Elegant to kindly speak?
Yeah. Good afternoon, everyone. Also, we have I look for
thank you, Amit. Now, may I request Mr. Shalin Bansal? Mr. Shalin Bansal?
Yeah. My name is Shalin Bansal, and I represent a company called Embark Technology Private Limited, and we have developed a software product called Finance Secure. It's a GPS tracking and fleet management software. And if you can see my screen right now, we have partners around 40 countries, including Zambia also. And you can see some vehicles moving in Lusaka in Zambia. And you can see icons in different colors like green, yellow, red, purple, depending on whether vehicle is moving or stationary or idling. And it's a very wonderful software. And it can be used in multiple applications like tracking of vehicles, tracking of children, tracking of pets, tracking of virtually anything which is moving. Like Zambia is a landlocked country. So a lot of movement happens between Zambia and Tanzania. The goods have to go from Zambia to Tanzania and vice versa. So our software can help in tracking of those lorries which are moving between two different countries. So it's a wonderful opportunity, and anybody who's interested to know more about this solution may please contact me, and I'll be happy to provide more information on this. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Bansal. May I now invite Mr. S. K. Chaudhary to speak out? S. K. Ray Chaudhary. Mr. Chaudhary, please. Let me move to the next participant, Mr. Nitesh Jain from Hitesh Infotech.
Hello, everyone. This is Nitesh from Hitesh Infotech. I'm giving just a brief intro about us. Like, Hitesh Infotech is an IT service provider company. We are purely service-based company providing solutions in web and mobile technologies, IoT-based softwares. We founded in 2006 and like providing the services over the globe, over to around 27 countries. So like love to like chat further to get details and to serve as per your requirement. I'm putting my details for chat window as well. Thank you.
Thank you. May I now invite Mr. Timir Shah from Ishani Infotech. Mr. Timir, please.
First of all, thank you very much, Vikrant and EAC dignitaries and the delegation from Zambia. Hi, this is Timir Bisha representing my company Ishanya Innovations Private Limited. With having a personal and professional experience of 25 plus years in terms of IoT, IT, ITES and ICT enabled services, products and solutions, we have customizedly developed and innovated 190 different customized concepts in terms of solutions related to smart warehousing, supply chain management, factory automations, educations, or any infra, commercial building, parking, any infrastructure automations with mix and match combinations of networking, RFID, sensor base, any technology in Wi-Fi base, fiber base, LoRa base. So we are happy to discuss any or other solutions which really been innovative, where time, money, energy can save and ROI will be at highest level. So once again, this is Timir Bisha representing my company, Ishan Innovations Private Limited, and we are open to discuss with Zambian delegations in terms of JV collaborations for providing all the services and solutions in their region. And I have already put my details on chat box, our YouTube channel, website and LinkedIn profile. Thank you very much. Once again, Timir Bisha representing my company, Ishan Innovations Private Limited. Be smart, be safe, be automated. Thank you.
Thank you, Timir. Now, may I request Madam Ruchi Singh to kindly speak? Ruchi, ma'am, please. Anyways, let me invite Mr. Ashutosh Agarwal.
Hi, everybody. My name is Ashutosh. I am from Tesca Technologies Private Limited, Jaipur. So we are manufacturing equipments for education, basically. So I'll just take you through a 4-page profile of ours. Can you see my screen? Like everybody can see my screen?
Yes.
Hello?
Yeah.
Can you see my screen? Okay. So we are manufacturing solutions for TVET, skill development, education and industry. And we are ISO and CE certified. So mainly our projects are based for Africa, wherein we are doing projects for Ministry of Education, African Development Banks, Islamic Funded Development Bank projects. So anything to do with the education and industry. So in terms of educational laboratories like science labs, physics, chemistry, biology, engineering, electrical equipments, electronics equipments. So this is the kind of small portfolio what we do: vocational training equipment, mechanical lab equipment, civil survey equipment, scientific and laboratory equipment. So we provide the entire solution to the government or to the dealers or distributors with whom we participate. So we have done a lot of projects with Ministry of Uganda, Ministry of Education in Uganda, Tanzania, Kenya, Ethiopia, Nigeria, but Zambia we are looking for in the Zambian market. So we supply to almost 85 plus countries worldwide, and a lot of exhibitions we participate. So this is all about us. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Ashutosh. Again, what would you like to speak? Mrs. Ruchi Singh.
I am Ruchi Singh from Roo Project Consulting. We are looking for partnership and collaborations in Zambia. We are also looking for distributors for our products. We have a smart face lock, which is nowadays technology, which is basically for detecting mask and also for the door access control. It is something which is touchscreen and AI based. So this particular product, we would like to look for a dealer and distributor, master distributor in Zambia. We are also looking to collaborate on services. Our company is ISO 9000-2015 certified company, and we are tech partners. We basically serve the services like web technologies. We are also serving on IoT, and we are serving on Android and iOS both. So we are here looking for collaborations and partnership with Zambia closely, so that we can have a good standing in Africa. Thank you very much, and we wish you a safe and healthy time ahead.
Thank you, madam. With this, we are over with the Indian side. And let me request Mr. Paul to kindly take over to introduce something. Mr. Naba Paul.
Hello, good afternoon. I would now, my name is Naba Paul, First Secretary Commerce in the Indian High Commission. I will now like to introduce some participants from the Zambia side, from various companies. First of all, I would like to invite Mr. Bijoy Netikatan, the CEO of NetOn. Mr. Bijoy, please.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone in India, and good afternoon, good morning to everyone in Zambia. So I'm the CEO of NetOn, which is a leading systems integration business in Zambia. We also own and operate a data center facility. It's a carrier neutral tier 3 data center in Zambia, which has now been operational for about 7 years. We're also embarking into the payments landscape now. We're launching a carrier neutral payments platform, very similar to what you have in India as Paytm, so on and so forth. So thank you for setting up this opportunity, and we look forward to interacting with you all in coming times. Thank you.
Thank you, Bijoy. Next, I would like to invite Mr. Shilo Mulenga, please. Mr. Mulenga?
Hello, good morning. Hello.
Yes, please go ahead.
I'm the representative for Infotech and Data Power Limited. We are into content management, records management. So we are a relatively new company in Zambia. So we're looking for partnership, of course, in the industry of record management, partners that will be able to provide peripherals in terms of softwares and other gadgets such as scanners, shredders, computers, and servers. So yes, we really looking forward to partnership. We have a lot to learn as well as interact. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kampamba. I would like to now invite Mr. Krishnan Jagadishwaran, CEO of Specialized Systems Zambia.
No. Good morning, team Zambia, His Excellency. India. My name is Jagadishwaran. Nabal, are you able to hear me?
Yeah, please go ahead.
I am the manager. We are the leaders in telecom vertical, and also medical equipment. For partnerships with vendors who can provide us with the state-of-the-art ICT solutions, mainly into education software. I've seen a few give some presentations. They can contact me. And anything to do with artificial intelligence and call center solutions or void is full. Intelligence and medical equipments and healthcare, I would prefer. You may also see that there is a website of smartvillages.org that I put, which is an NGO that we have started. Anyone interested in rural development can also contact me. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. KJ. Now, next, I would like to invite Mr. Goswat Mukisha. He is the CEO of Southern Scale Services Limited, Zambia. Mr. Mukisha. Okay. Maybe we'll come back to him again. Mr. A. Swaminathan is Director, New Tech Business Systems. Mr. Jyotinath Sinha, Indo Zambia Bank.
Yeah, good morning to Zambia and good afternoon to India. My name is Jyotinath Sinha. I'm a head of IT in Indo Zambia Bank. So Indo-Zambia Bank is an incorporated commercial bank, which was registered on 19th of October, 1984 in Zambia as a joint venture between the government of the Republic of Zambia and the government of India. Industrial Development Corporation, that is IDC, is holding a 40% share on behalf of the government of the Republic of Zambia, while 60% shares are held by the government of India through three state-owned banks. Namely Bank of Baroda 20%, Bank of India 20%, and Central Bank of India 20%. So bank has been experiencing steady growth during the last 5 years. We have moved from US in assets, we have moved from $155 million to $400 million. Bank, our technology initiatives are clearly focused on the customers. We have 24/7 ATM services are running. Our internet banking, mobile banking, e-statements, all alternate delivery channels are very fully functional. We have a FlexCube as a core banking solution. And recently we have upgraded our digital banking channels that are appreciated by our customers. We are having our own state-of-the-art data center and the disaster recovery site with real-time integration between both the sides, DC and DR. The banks offer many commercial banking solutions like internet banking, mobile banking, debit cards, international fund transfer, domestic fund transfers. We offer tax online payments to customers. Even customers can pay their pensions for using our platform. And many more we are using right now. I've seen a lot of companies we can work together to improve my customer service, my bank customer service. And we'll see how it will move further. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Sinha. I would now like to invite Mr. Arijit Datta, CEO of Madison General Insurance. Mr. Datta, are you there?
Hello. Yeah, I am Arijit Datta. I am the Chief Operations Officer for Madison General Insurance. With me is Sridhar also. So he is the IT manager. So Madison General Insurance is a Zambian company, Zambian General Insurance Company. We are in General Insurance. We are the second largest in Zambia. But digital, as far as digital channels are concerned, we are the leaders. We have been winning awards and we are the leaders in selling insurance and providing service digitally. And we want to, you know, on two areas where IT is very important for us is we, Sridhar will introduce you to what we have presently, but we would like to move into the retail space, not in a brick mortar kind of branches, but we would like to use digital channels, telecom channels, and those things to reach out to get new customers, especially in the retail segment from rural areas, semi-rural areas. We want to tap into those digitally and try to get on board those customers into with the mass market products. That's our focus, and there it can be only through IT enabled services. So we are just working on it, and Sridhar will just introduce on what we use presently.
Good morning to Zambia team and good afternoon to India team. As Mr. Arjit spoken, like he has been briefly introduced about Madison General Insurance Company. Coming to the IT side, like what we have is the core system on insurance platform. We do have a B2B, business-to-business system, which interacts with our agents and brokers portfolio. And B2C, business-to-customers, which interacts with our direct clients, where our clients can log into our portal anytime to buy insurance at their own convenience of time. And we have some in-house developed salvage portal where our salvage buyers who are willing to buy salvage, they can log into our salvage portal to buy salvages at any point of time. And we do also, we have done some integrations with our RATSA, which is road traffic systems, and where our clients can buy road tax online immediately when they purchase insurance with our company. That's all. That's basically about our IT side.
Thank you so much. Have a good day.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, Madison team. I would like to now invite Mr. Pankaj Jain of Safal, Zambia. Is there? Mr. Pankaj Jain. Pankaj Jain or Shreya Jain? No. Right. Then I would like to request Mr. Binod Menon. He is the CEO of Sonar International, Zambia. Mr. Menon, your voice, you need to unmute.
Sorry. Good day to all. Thanks for the invitation, and it has been really interesting to interact with everybody. I'm not into the IT field. I'm the managing director for Sonar International. We are one of the largest importers of steel into Zambia. And most of our systems are automated, so we always look for IT solutions. We got cut and bend operations where you use again systems to do all the yield and everything. And I'm also the secretary for the Indian Business Council of Zambia, which works under the Indian High Commission. Any of you are interested in setting up everything in Zambia, any help you require, you can always contact me. We'll be too glad to, along with our other board members, we'll be too glad to help you in terms of anything which you require from Zambia. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Menon. I would now like to request Mr. Argya Sinha of Computec to take over.
Hi, good morning, team.
Morning, Zambia, Lusaka, and afternoon, India. So we are 35 years old system integration in rather sense and ICT solution providers. We are headquartered in Kenya and Nairobi and present across Pan-African. So we are mainly into, we have a handful of only products in our baskets. Mainly starting, we are one of the biggest distributor for Nixtoff, Diebold Nixtoff ATMs across Africa. Big banks like Indo-Zambia, my friend is there who spoke just now, Zanacos, the Atlas Maras, all the Diebold Nixtoff outright purchase, as well as the services, the maintenance, everything is taken care by us from past 30 years. Having said that, we are also the gold and the silver partners for companies like Cisco. We do a lot of corporate works under Cisco, Microsoft. Also looking for Indian companies. I'm already working with a handful of Indian companies on the software solution providers, particularly for the banking softwares, many of them. So, and might be many of my colleagues who are here, listed here, knows me also. I'm working with them. So any requirement, I'm ready to partnership with solutions like in the software solutions for banking, financials, corporates, and any hardware ICT requirements. So let's welcome and take this relationship forward. And we are a very old company. Everyone knows I am the director of this company based out of Lusaka, Zambia. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Sinha, for that great presentation. I would now like to invite Dr. Imran Patel of A1 Dental. Dr. Patel. I see Dr. Patel is present with us online, but it seems Dr. Patel.
Hello, good morning.
Yes.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning to our chief guest, His Excellency Mr. Mukula Makasa, Honorable Secretary to High Commissioner of India, Managing Director of ECS India, Executive Director ECS, Mr. Gurmeet Singh. My name is Dr. Imran Patel. I'm representing Ministry of Health, Levy Manawasa Medical University. Today, I would like to talk about the scope of information technology in healthcare and healthcare education. So information technology, particularly healthcare, is nationwide of innovation. In the IT, in healthcare, it's play an important role in healthcare. As an electronic healthcare record management system, personal health record management system, electronic prescribing, telecommunication from the world, the various specialty field doctors, telemedication concept, and virtual learning platforms for students and for the academia. So here I would strongly suggest the health IT concept will be the game changer concept in the nationwide in the country of Zambia. Thank you very much for my contribution.
Thank you, Dr. Patel. I'd like to now request Mr. Saugata Banerjee of White Orchid Investments, Zambia.
Good morning to everyone in Zambia and good afternoon to everyone in India. I represent a company called White Orchid Investments Limited. We are based out of Lusaka, Zambia, and have our presence also at the moment in Democratic Republic of Congo. We are basically into the field of aviation along with FMCG and fertilizer distribution, water purification systems, as well as into the field of we are approaching into the field of fuels and mining sectors. We are in constant need of IT solutions in terms of inventory management as well as sales management. So I am willing to get into a discussion or any other partnership with any IT company who are working in this domain of inventory management. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Banerjee. I will try to sort of go through my list again to see if those who I missed out earlier are, can join us or not. Mr. Josephat Mukisha. No, Mr. Swaminathan. Mr. Pankaj Jain. I see a couple of them are logged in, but like I don't seem them responding. Anyhow, from the Zambian side, from the companies from the Zambian side, I think that's all. Now, thank you very much, and hope the companies on the Indian side and the Zambian side will be able to take the discussions further onwards. And now, over to you back, Mr. Vikrant.
Thank you so much, Mr. Nabakumar Paul. Mr. Paul is our first secretary in the Indian High Commission in Lusaka, Zambia, and he was quite instrumental in affecting and supporting today's event for the benefit of both the sides. Thank you so much, sir, for supporting today's initiative. I think some of the companies were quite interested, and and we see a lot of synergies wherein both the sides of Indian sides and the Zambian side can work together and create a win-win synergy and win-win situations for both the sides. And we have other some of the team members who have supported today's event, Ms. Roseline, and from the Zambian Development Agency, thank you so much. And from Team ESE, we have our senior colleagues in the ESE, Mr. Vikas Gupta, Mr. Vikrant Saxena, and Ms. Seema Kakkar. Thank you so much, everyone, for today's initiative and joining us and interacting with each other today. And Ms. Roseline, if any of the Indian companies or Zambian companies who inadvertently left out and would like to speak out and introduce themselves, here's still a window open. You're most welcome to unmute yourself and introduce yourself, or else we can call this session to an end.
Thank you, Mr. Vikas. This is Saurabh this side. I'm the managing director for RA Consulting Services Zambia. Yeah. And RA Consulting Services is actually about more than 25 years of experience in Africa continent. Our headquarters is in Botswana, and we operate in Mauritius, Botswana, Zambia, planning to open up in Malawi and Mozambique and other sub-African continent. And we are the HP and HPE authorized partner for the services. Like, we're the highest level of partnership in SADC region. On the VMware side also, we are competent, and we also have cloud solutions based on to our clientele to provide them not to spend on the legacy infrastructure and all. So MCB, the Mauritius Bank, and lots of Mauritius companies are with us on a local cloud solution, because as per the bank norms, you are not allowed to take the data outside in Mauritius. So we provide them those solutions to them. And the similar sort of, we maintaining the RTGS system for Bank of Zambia here, and a lot of banks, Electoral Commission, ZRA, and all the big companies which are there, they are with our support, maintaining the data centers for Airtel and MTN. And so all these projects we are handling and managing them. So that is small about our group. So we are more than welcome if anybody is looking forward for an opportunity or a good tie up with us, we can work together. Thank you.
Thank you, Saurabh, for the introduction. And I will request all of our participants, both from the Indian side and the Zambian side, to please put your contact details and a short brief description on the chat box, so that the same can be shared with both the sides, and that can be used later on for the networking and further interactions between the two companies. And with this, I call this session on the close. And thank you so much, everyone. And I must thanks once again for our High Commission and our partner for today's event, the Zambian Development Agency, for making this virtual event happen. And thank you so much for Indian industry and the Zambian industry for sparing time to join us today. And I request everyone to make use of these virtual events that the Council is being organizing as a part of its global outreach program to get benefited out of these difficult times. And I'm sure these can create win-win synergies from both the sides and opportunities with each other. Thank you so much, everyone, once again. Okay. And
thank you. Thanks a lot. On behalf of the High Commission of India, I would like to thank all the participants, the ESC, all the participants, and also I would like to acknowledge the presence of Smart Zambia, who also logged in with a team of officers and are present here. And so I would like to thank everyone once again, you know, for making this meeting possible. And we are always available here to facilitate the connection between our companies in India and our companies in Zambia. Thank you very much.
And Mr. Paul, we don't mind if Smart Zambia would like to introduce themselves quickly. Are they available?
I'm not sure, but the Smart Zambia has been in touch with us. So okay. We will make them, provide you their contacts, and they will, I'm sure, be able to, you know, interact with you.
Great. That would be great. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Thank you, Mr. Paul.
Yes, please.
Yeah, thanks a lot, sir. I'm Vikram. And thanks, Rosalind, too.
Thank you. You're welcome. Yes, can you do one thing from the chat box? Can you just try to copy whatever is there in the chat box?